Hey guys, Sean Nalawani here of seannal.com and bodytransformationtruth.com. And today I want to briefly discuss buffered creatine versus creatine monohydrate. Which is more effective? Which one do I recommend and why? So when creatine monohydrate first came onto the scene back in the early 1990s, it pretty much changed the bodybuilding supplement world forever. No other natural muscle building substance is backed by more concrete research demonstrating clear, significant effects on muscle growth and performance than creatine. And ever since then, an endless number of new and improved versions of creatine have popped up, each one claiming to be superior to the original monohydrate in a variety of ways. Buffered creatine is one of the most popular of these forms, and it apparently uses a molecular buffering process that creates a 100% stable form of buffered creatine that is less likely to be converted into the waste product creatinine. It's claimed to be up to 10 times more powerful than standard monohydrate, and it's claimed to have no bloating or cramping, no necessity for a loading phase, and greater creatine uptake into the muscle cells. But what is the reality behind these claims? Well, first of all, it should be noted that the first two points are essentially irrelevant. Yes, buffered creatine does not cause bloating and or cramping, and it does not require a loading phase, but neither does regular creatine monohydrate. The apparent problems that are associated with standard creatine monohydrate are typically only put forward by companies who are selling new and improved versions of creatine, but they have no real grounding in any scientific research. When using a high quality form of creatine at the recommended 3 to 5 gram per day dosage, creatine monohydrate has been consistently shown to be both completely safe and effective. And it should also be noted that the most popular brand of buffered creatine still contains about 98% creatine monohydrate, with the buffer making up the other 2%. So what about the actual effects of buffered creatine versus creatine monohydrate? Well, a new study was actually released fairly recently, back in September 2012, in the Journal of the International Society of Sports Nutrition, that examined this issue in quite a bit of detail. It was a double-blind study with 36 participants, and they supplemented with creatine using the following protocols. The first group was standard creatine monohydrate using a loading phase of 20 grams a day for 5 days, followed by a standard maintenance phase. The second group used the manufacturer's recommended dosage of buffered creatine, which was 1.5 grams per day. And the third group used the buffered creatine, but at the same dosing protocol as the first creatine monohydrate group. And here's what the researchers found. On the issue of creatine absorption and effects on muscle mass and performance, neither manufacturer's recommended doses or equivalent loading doses of buffered creatine promoted greater changes in muscle creatine content, body composition, strength, or anaerobic capacity than creatine monohydrate. These findings do not support claims that buffered creatine is a more efficacious form of creatine. On the issue of safety, neither manufacturer's recommended doses or equivalent loading doses of buffered creatine compared to creatine monohydrate resulted in any negative side effects or health outcomes. Additionally, there was no evidence that creatine monohydrate supplementation experienced a greater degradation of creatinine. These findings suggest that buffered creatine is just as safe to consume as creatine monohydrate with minimal side effects. And the final word, buffered creatine supplementation does not promote greater changes in muscle creatine content, body composition, or training adaptations in comparison to creatine monohydrate. And buffered creatine supplementation does not exhibit a safer clinical profile or have less side effects in comparison to creatine monohydrate. And I'll link that study in the description box below if you want to check it out yourself. In addition to this, it should be noted that on a gram-for-gram basis, buffered creatine is significantly more expensive than regular creatine monohydrate at roughly 20 cents per gram, depending on where you buy it from, compared to roughly 3 cents per gram for standard creatine monohydrate. And that makes it about 7 times more expensive. My suggestion is to examine the claims, review the concrete research that I provided, compare the prices, and then just go ahead and make up your mind for yourself. So, thanks a lot for watching this video. If you did find the information useful here today, please make sure to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe to stay up to date on all of my future video lessons. Make sure to check out my complete step-by-step muscle building and fat loss programs over at bodytransformationtruth.com. The link to that is in the description box below. And make sure to join the Facebook page for daily tips and updates. The link for that is also in the description box. Talk to you again soon.